Y'all, these people had me hot. I almost got out of character and slapped these people.
These niggas weak. They been testing me all week, just let me be. Blowing me up, I'm trying to sleep. I ain't your freak, so don't be calling after three. I do what these bitches don't, that's why they running back to me. Run the cash up, run the cash. Run the cash up.
I have to tell you about these McDonald's employees because they're out of pocket. And they're not just employees, they're managers. Like, who? So, y'all, I don't even know if I'm supposed to say these people's names or can do that, but I'm going to do it anyway because what you going to do, sue me? And? Anyway, this happened at the Cape Canaveral McDonald's in Florida. Right by the beach, right there. And this involved me, a horrible high manager named Cody, who never did his job, who always wanted to leave when it got busy. Another manager named Patty. I actually liked her, but I hate her now because she way out of line. And this other girl named Brittany. We call her Big Brittany because she was Big Brittany, and there was another little Brittany, but she was Big Brittany. So yes. Had the most annoying voice ever. I don't care. Most annoying voice ever. Like, y'all should have heard it. Tell y'all about Cody. Ooh, Cody. So, I've worked there since May 2019, right? So, I usually didn't work the night shift, but when I did, there was this manager named Cody. He was, like, always the closer or whatever. So, when I'd work there, he would come at me, like, out of pocket. He'd be like, he would say, like, little, like, racist jokes or statements or whatever. So, like, one time he said, oh, I see they hired your sister talking about another black girl in the store. And me, I was like, what the hell? And I just walked off. Because me, I'm not a confrontation person. That's the problem. I need to start calling people out on their bullcrap. Because when people know you're not going to call them out on their bullcrap, they want to just walk all over you and say whatever they want. But I'm not that no more because you don't try my life. You didn't do too much. Anyway, some other statements he's done said is, oh, I had a cut on my finger. And he was like, oh, why do you have a cut on your finger? From all the rioting? Because of the Black Lives Matter movement is going on. And once again, Black Lives Matter, period. As always. So I was like, and then he has also said, I was in the window, mind y'all. He walked up to me because he was the only manager at this time. Everybody else was like on break or like in the kitchen. He walked up to me and was like, the next white guy that comes to the window, you should say, are you my dad? Yes, y'all. And when are you going to give my mom child support? Y'all, ridiculous. This is what I deal with. Take an intermediate break for my doggo. Ah! Cutie patootie, I like the way she shake it. Go ahead and earthquake it. She's so cute. Anyway, back to the story. So, yes, Cody has said all those things. He's out of pocket, really ridiculous. And Ben should have spoke up, but me being the non-confrontational person, me being the person who didn't want to have an awkward work environment, was like, okay, I'm gonna let this slide. But you should never let stuff slide like this. Never. Because when you do, people think they can say whatever the heck they want to say in front of you, and they think it's okay when it's never okay to make no racist jokes for any race at any time. It's never cool. Anyway, so I go into work August 20th. Okay, I worked only 1 to 6 because I cut down my hours because I don't like to work, honestly. But I got money and I'm all about my co-op, so get to it. Anyway, so on August 20th, I worked 1 to 6, so around 3, a manager named Debbie went on break, right? So then Around that time, a customer orders a large black coffee. This all started with a large black coffee, y'all. That's how you know people are racist, because it comes with a large black coffee. Are you serious? Anyway, so Cody goes, why is it a large black coffee? Why can't it be a large white coffee? Y'all, in my head, I'm like, who the heck says this? Like, why are you doing the most? Anyway. So, yeah, he's just going on about that. I'm like, so then, Patty, the other manager, and his big Brittany go into a conversation, y'all. So they start talking about Black Lives Matter movement and this and that. So Cody and Brittany start talking about the N-word, y'all. I don't even like saying the N-word. It makes me awkward when I hear people saying N-word, like, just because. It's just, like, just no. Especially some white people, because, like, what are y'all doing? Stop the madness. So they're just like, I don't get the point. I don't get why it's so offensive to some people. And some people, it's not offensive at all. I feel like it's not even that big of a deal. It's just, like, the word bro. And I don't get why it's so offensive to some. You don't have to get it. You don't have to get it at all. But I'm just confused on why y'all heck y'all having this conversation. What? You don't have to get why. You don't have to get it. Just don't use the word. Don't say N-word. Don't use the word. Don't think about it. Who cares? Oh my gosh, what was that word? I don't know. Exactly. That's how I need you to be. N-word? What? Yes. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. You're doing too much. You're white. I don't know why the heck you're even worried about the word. Stop the madness. So yeah, I hear them talking about that. I'm like, okay. So then Brittany goes, all lives matter. No problem with you saying all lives matter, but y'all, we at work, y'all. I'm in the corner like, I don't do politics because I don't do politics. One, I'm not about to start talking about it. Like, what the hell? So yeah, she says all lives matter. No problem with her statement. She can believe all lives matter, but don't say that at work when I don't care to hear about it, okay? One thing you don't talk about at work, or pretty much a lot of places, is your religious views, your political views, and controversial stuff like this. I don't know what the hell they were thinking, but who knows. So yes, okay, then they get into the whole George Floyd incident, right? I can't speak because that's how hot these people had me. Yes, so Cody goes, oh, have you seen the whole video? Have you seen the whole video? He's refusing, and he wasn't really complying, and he was just doing too much. He wasn't so innocent in the matter. Patty goes, Patty, this white, elderly-seeming woman, I don't know how old she is, probably like 50, 60, around that age, I don't know, ain't got no farther than McDonald's. But anyway, let's not do too much. She goes, yeah, I seen it, and he deserved it. Girl, boy, whoever you are watching this, I said, ooh. What the hell she just said? What the hell did this white lady just say? Who don't know nothing about nothing? What the hell did this white lady just say? He deserved it. Y'all. I kept my composure, but you know what I wanted to do was kick her in her throat, drag her out the dang restaurant, take her through the drive-thru by her hair, because if I would have did that to you, did you deserve it? I'm just so confused. Okay. You can believe he wasn't complying or whatever, but I don't feel like nobody deserves to get laid on, have a whole person laying on their neck until they suffocate and die. A little extreme. Not a little, it's very extreme. In front of an open street, in front of everybody. Like, where the heck are we? Are we in a medium of times at this point? Because what the hell? Yes. Okay. So I was like, amazing. So Debbie comes in. The manager who went on break. She comes in and I go, oh, so when is the GM coming? She says, she should be in here this week. And I say, okay, can I get her number? Because guess what? I'm taking it to the next level. Because y'all want to disrespect me, and y'all want to say all this stuff in front of my face, a young black woman. Okay. All right, watch this. So, the whole incident happened August 19th, and I worked 1 to 6, so it happened around 3 o'clock. So, I got the GM lady's number, and I called her up. I texted her and I said, when's the next time you'll be in? Because I have to file a complaint, right? I have to file a complaint because these people are trying me. Okay. So, she tells me tomorrow. So, I go in Thursday around 11 o'clock. She's running behind, so she comes in. Then she's like, oh, the HR lady named Amanda. Oh, the GM lady's name is Kathy. I don't know any of these people's last name, but you can just see the first names. Who cares? And the HR lady's name is Amanda, right? So she comes in. I tell them about the whole incident, right? And I'm like, this is a hostile work environment. I don't want to work here no more. And I told them I quit right there, right? So when I told them that, she was like, Kathy, the GM, was like, no, I don't want you to leave the store, this and that. We're going to have several talking to them. We're going to have several talks with them, this and that. And we can make it as if we didn't hear it from you. Sus. One, McDonald's is very gossipy. All they do is gossip. They see me here in non-work clothes on a non-work day, sitting here talking to you. They know what just happened yesterday when they want to say some stupid things such as he deserved it. And the N-word is not that offensive. So obviously it was me who told. So I don't know what you're talking about. There's always going to be some hostility. There's always going to be some awkwardness in the air. I'm not working here no more. I don't care. So then she's like, oh, I can transfer you, this and that. So I was like, but no, I quit totally. I don't care. Because let me tell you why these people have me messed up. So as I said before, Cody and Patty are managers. Brittany is just an employee, but she's been there for like a while now. So I don't think they're gonna fire Cody or Patty. They're not gonna do nothing, honestly, because listen here, this is what they told me. We're gonna have several talks with them, and that was so out of line, and we just had to talk about this, how certain things should not be said in the workplace. And then they started making excuses for Cody. Really? You want to make excuses for his racist jokes? So they go. I just feel like he tries to be a clown in the workplace. He tries to be funny. And I feel like if I would have spoke up and told him how I feel and that I didn't really like his jokes, that he would have apologized instantly. Yes, I should have. But the thing is, I shouldn't have to. You're a manager. You know how to act. You're old, 27 years old, or however old he is. He looked like 45. Don't want to hear about it. Just. Yeah. Oh, God, these people got me on all over again. But anyway, I shouldn't have to tell no manager that they shouldn't say racist jokes to my face or at any time in a workplace. I'm so confused on how that was my job. Where was that in my job description? You're a whole adult. You should know how to act in society. You should have common sense. I'm so confused. Yeah, so they want to make excuses like that for him. Oh, okay. And pretty much, I feel like nothing was going to get done. I've never had no racist comments thrown at me or experienced racism firsthand. But like, this really opened my eyes. This experience really opened my eyes. I had been working there for a whole year, y'all. From May 2019 to just August 2020 when I just quit, like a couple days ago. And it's just really blowing me how like white people close ranks and protect the people. Not, I get that they're managers, so yeah, I already knew they was gonna protect them, right? But so I get they was gonna protect them or whatever, but like, really, you're gonna make excuses for these people? And then also, listen, y'all, you know how white people be like, one of my best friends are black, or I have a black friend. These people, the GM and the HR lady, go and say, I don't think Brittany meant anything. This is the one who said the all is not a ring. I don't think Brittany meant anything because Marion's her best friend. Marion is a black lady who works at the store. So I know you did not just use the whole I have a black friend as an excuse. yes, these people said this. I wish I would have recorded this conversation because I know they would deny it to this day. I know they would deny it because, like, are you serious? Who the hell says this stuff? Why would I lie? I actually like the people. I love the people I worked with. It was a really good environment, except for whenever I worked with Cody because he was always saying out of line stuff. And then until this experience, because one, I can never work with y'all again. I will snap on y'all. I really will. I'm such a nice girl. I'm such a nice person. I'm really kind of shy at times when I don't know you. But, like, some things I just will not tolerate. Like, the disrespect you're going to have to say that in front of me. Or the disrespect you're just going to have in general to say that. Because... But, yes. Like, it really opened my eyes to how white people close ranks and protect their own. Like, they're not going to do anything about it. I already know it. They're just going to talk to them and be like, oh, y'all shouldn't have said that. Y'all already know that. I don't know what y'all was thinking, this and that. What does that do? What does it do? So, at the whole incident, I got home and told my grandma, granddaddy, and my mother. Y'all should have seen my mother. She was so hot. But I get that, you know, like, she a mama bear. She gonna try to, like, rip these people's throats out or whatever. So, I had already quit. She was like, Aisha, you shouldn't have quit because this and that. I'm like, I still can't go to HR. I mean, not HR, because that lady ain't did nothing ever. She ain't do nothing either. Her name Amanda, just let y'all know. They all suck. So I still can go to corporate. I'm still gonna work on that, but I got other stuff to do right now. I'm trying to focus on school, this and that. But y'all, this whole experience was so crazy, because I just never expected it to happen. Well, like, with Cody, okay, yeah. But Patty... When she said that, I was like, nah, girl, I really work with, like, some Nazis, some racists, some white supremacists, some crazy behind people. Like, do they even like me for real? Because they be speaking to me like they like me, but I don't think they like me. Definitely don't think they like me. How they be acting. But yes, y'all, it's ridiculous. So, and nothing's going to get done about it. I know that, because I'm going to double check up. I'm gonna go to the store in a month or whatever and ask, does Cody still work here? Does Patty still work here? This and that, because I bet they're still gonna be working there, and it's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. I don't think anybody should still be dealing with racism at this point in their time. It's whole 2020. Get it together. What are we doing? Like, what was the reason for you to say that? Especially in front of a young black woman. What were you thinking? Who knows? You weren't ridiculous. Anyway. Yes, that's my story time, y'all. If y'all ever go to the McDonald's in Cape Canaveral, Florida, order a lot of food and then just drive off because, or just be an a-hole because, you know, they kind of deserve it. If you see Cody or Patty, cuss them out because they deserve it. And yeah, that's my story time.